Get your logo looking like this to this by learning about pixels and vectors. So why points and not pixels? Raster or bitmap images are described by an array or map of bits within a rectangular grid of pixels or dots. Vector images are described by lines, shapes, and other graphic image components stored in a format that incorporates geometric formulas for rendering the image elements. At 100% view perspective, the bitmap or raster version of the image looks almost the same as a vector version. But notice as soon as the raster version is scaled or zoomed in, the pixels on the edge begin to show and the edges no longer look smooth. The vector image is created by defining points and curves. When vector graphics are scaled, the edges remain crisp and sharp no matter the size. The main benefit of a vector project or file type is infinite scalability. This is important with things like logos, so you don't have to worry about losing quality if you increase the size or scale. So, if it's formatted for a small business card or a large billboard, it will keep the same quality if you do the project A to Z as a vector. Here are some common vector file types. AI is the Adobe Illustrator artwork file. EPS is encapsulated PostScript. SVG is scalable vector graphic, and PDF is portable document format. AI is the native format for Adobe Illustrator, which designers use to make logos as well as other branding elements such as printed materials and illustrations. The vector-based file is always editable with Adobe Illustrator and doesn't reduce the quality of your file. AI files are famous for the high quality they provide and other design editing options. EPS logo files are highly compatible vector files that can be used in many design editors. You can edit and resize them without any changes in quality. These files are considered master files and are mostly used in graphic design and large-scale professional printing. Raster files too can be saved as EPS files and behave as vectors. SVG files are mostly used for the web. SVG logos can be scaled to any size without losing quality, similar to other vector files. It's the W3C vector graphic standard, so you can use these in support for any screen resolution. These files are XML based, thus it's possible to view them in browsers and also within different devices and softwares like Adobe Illustrator. These files have transparent backgrounds and are ideal for logos. SVG logos are mostly used for print materials, website images, and icons. Additionally, SVG logos can be animated and used along with a CSS file type. Another common vector logo format is PDF, which can be viewed in Adobe Acrobat Reader, web browsers, or even the Finder window. It's a great way to view a logo or type text and other printed material in a PDF before you start using them. Logos in a PDF format can be easily converted when you need them in different types of image formats. A designer can export your logo as a PDF file in Adobe Illustrator. However, it's not the only software that can create it. A PDF logo can be generated in Photoshop, PowerPoint, and some other raster software, which means it will stop being a vector at that time. Though it has limited editing options, PDFs make it extremely convenient for sharing your files. In short, PDFs are a great format for viewing pieces, but not great for editing and for designing. What if I'm not sure what type of image I have? To know for sure, open up your file and get a close-up look at a part of your design. If you see the vector editing nodes, you'll confirm that it's a vector graphic. If I create an image as a raster, can I convert it later to a vector? Yes, depending on which software system that you're using. It will require different steps. Generally, I suggest sticking with one file type and editing program if possible, so you don't have to keep converting back and forth. If you're working in Photoshop, for example, the Image Trace tool lets you convert raster images like JPEG, PNG, and PSD to vector artworks. Using this feature, you can easily base new drawings on an existing piece of artwork by tracing it. For example, you can convert the image of a handmade sketch you've drawn on a paper into a vector artwork using an image trace tool. Are there any benefits to using raster? Some of the advantages of raster graphics include the following. They're easy to use. They provide subtle gradations of color. They are simple to edit using most common programs like Photoshop and Microsoft Paint. Raster graphics are also used when it's important to show smooth transitions of shapes and colors, for example, in photos. Raster graphics are also excellent for catalogs, flyers, postcards, stationery, and other everyday projects. Raster graphics are great when creating complex and detailed images. But if you plan to enlarge your raster image, the starting image must be high quality or else you may end up with a blurry image. When should I choose raster over vector graphics? For photos, you need raster images. For letterhead, text, logos, or other simple graphic elements, you need a vector image. If you're not totally sure which type to choose, here are some guidelines that could help. If you're editing photos with multiple colors, choose raster images. If you're doing a drawing with a limited number of colors, choose vector images. What's the best logo size? On the screen now, we'll put our recommended file size and ratios. For logos, generally I suggest sticking with a square format. This is most versatile in a lot of cases. Do I need a transparent logo? If you have a transparent version, that will make your life a lot easier in the future. It's very easy to use transparent logos in different parts of your brand. Logos on transparent backgrounds are mostly used for websites and social media pages, branding material, and products. The biggest advantage of transparent logos is that they go well with any color palette and design elements. You also can easily upload your transparent image to your website without worrying about a boxy outline. Also, transparent logos are often used as watermarks on copyright images. So if you're an artist, photographer, or videographer, this is important. What color system do I use? If you're unfamiliar with color systems, there are two of them in design, CMYK and RGB. RGB stands for red, green, blue, and is used mostly in digital design. CMYK stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key, which is black. On the other hand, is primarily used for print. This is essential to know because not all formats support both color systems, meaning not all logo file formats will be suitable for printing. EPS, PDF, and AI are file formats supporting both RGB and CMYK. When you make your logo on Renderforest, you can export it as PNG or SVG. Pro Plan and Business Plan subscribers get access to the Branding Guideline Package. This full package of branding guidelines includes your logo modes, variations, mockups, as well as your logo in multiple social media resolutions. This is a professional way to store your company information and an easy shareable format. Integrate your logo on graphics or posters, use it on company promo videos, or upload it to your website for cohesive branding. It's easy to switch between tools on Renderforest. Give it a try, get creative, and have some fun. Click the link above now to get started. I hope this cleared up any questions that you had about raster versus vector file types. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and ring that bell for more creative and branding tool tutorials. Thanks, and I'll see you next week.